Hello, everyone, and welcome to Channel 60 and especially to 60 Live. We hope that you stay tuned for the entire program because it could be life-changing for you. So please stay tuned. My name is Pat Huber. You're watching Christian television right here in the heart of the Delaware and the Lehigh Valley. But right now, we're going to get the show started. We have two people here from the Hope Pregnancy Center. And seated next to me is Nicole Showell. She is the executive director. And next to her is Vincent Calloway. He is on the advisory board. He's a member. And welcome to the program. It's nice to meet both of you.
Likewise.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming. Did you have a safe trip from the Philadelphia area?
We did, very much so. Thank you.
Good, good. Well, first of all, tell us about the conception of the Hope Center, a little bit of the history and what it's about and everything, so our audience has a general overview of the ministry.
Absolutely, and that's a great question. And in 2008, November 2008, the Hope Center opened its doors to serve the women and families of Philadelphia. Our pastor, Pastor Lusk, was burdened with this vision from the Lord to service this and to start saving the lives of babies in our city because they are dying at an astronomical rate. And he knew, and he spent a lot of time in prayer and knew that this was something that he had to do.
Praise God for men of faith like that.
Yes.
Amen, amen.
Also just I had a chance to hear the person that God used to really, I guess, light a fire under Pastor Lusk. Her name is Star Parker. I think she's been on the program The View in the past, but she really is a very powerful and passionate speaker and advocate for saving babies' lives. She shares her own testimony, but she really encouraged and even challenged Pastor Lusk, Herb Lusk, to really pray about and consider what God wanted him to do, especially in the inner city, the city of Philadelphia, where there's a disproportionate amount of abortions occurring with African-American children in particular. So through that, you know, this led to the start of the Hope Center.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now, why the need for this type of facility right where you are? Is there that much, is it epidemic proportion of the abortions that are going on there? I mean, I'm not aware of it because I'm not from the area.
And yes, and last year, 2008, there were over 38,000 abortions in Pennsylvania. More than 18,000 were in Philadelphia, so almost half of all of the abortions in the state are being done in Philadelphia.
I just received an email from a friend of mine from Florida, and it was about a surgeon that was operating on the baby in the mother's womb. Mm-hmm. It was so unbelievable, and the surgery was successful. And they took a picture because the little baby from the womb held on to the surgeon's finger.
Right, right.
Did you see that?
Yeah, I've seen that before.
Yeah, isn't that amazing?
Yes.
Oh,
I mean, there is a God.
Yes,
and
there
he is the creator of life. He really is. Mm-hmm. So now, the type of clients, when they come to the center, are they all seeking to have abortions or do they come because they think that you are pro-life, or what are they seeking when they actually come?
Good question. They cover the gamut. We see women who are set on having an abortion, and they think that we are an abortion provider. But we do not refer or provide any type of abortion.
You don't send them somewhere.
No, we certainly do not.
Oh, praise God.
Then we do have some who are life-minded, and they just seek counseling and support and resources, and we have others who just need counseling and who also have suffered from post-abortion stress, which is another really big factor in our city.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I just wanted to talk a little bit about that, briefly, post-abortion stress. By trade, I'm a marriage and family therapist, and I have a private practice in Philadelphia, and I actually see a tremendous amount of women, and post-abortion stress is a hidden cause of depression in many women. Mm-hmm. And it goes under the radar because abortion is such a political hot potato in our country. But as a clinician, the politics doesn't matter to me. I care about people getting well.
Mm-hmm.
And so post-abortion stress is really a form of post-traumatic stress disorder, really.
Right.
So I've actually treated women with that. And it also affects the men that are associated with the pregnancy as well. and I've also treated the men mm-hmm. and helped them to go through the grieving process, et cetera. So this is a real, real serious problem.
Oh, it is. I'm sure that really it is. Now, you're only open since 2008, so I've talked to other pro-life clinics as well, and we've had them on the program, and sometimes they say they see the same woman two or three times, you know? She's had an abortion, now she's pregnant again. Does she want to keep this one? And she said, it's like a revolving door for some of these women, and they're not even married. Have you remotely even experienced anything like that?
Absolutely.
Did you?
Absolutely.
Because I thought maybe you're so young that maybe you hadn't had that already.
No, not at all. We've experienced that on several occasions with the women that we see, the families that we see. Mm. And like you said, they look at abortion as a birth control method.
Yes.
And all too often, that's the normal for our women to go to become pregnant, have an abortion.
Mm-hmm.
A few months later, they're right. pregnant again, and they have the abortion.
Oh, so sad.
But part of the one of the very important pieces that we do provide is counseling.
Mm-hmm.
And we really help them to know Jesus and what love is.
Praise the Lord.
And that we want them to love not only their unborn baby, but themselves.
Yes.
And that's something that is very important to us when we are counseling the women and families at
mm-hmm.
Hope.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And something else, the people that are coming in to the centers, and it's mostly women, but the Hope Center becomes an avenue to do relationship education. That's you know, this is not just about helping couples make a decision to keep their baby, but it's about helping them to make good, healthy relationship choices. And
exactly.
they're coming from environments where they are absolutely, if I can use the term, clueless
mm-hmm.
about what healthy relationship looks like. So we really have an opportunity to really impact the community by doing a lot of relationship education as well.
That's wonderful. Now, are there fees? Like if someone thinks that they're pregnant, can they come in and get a free pregnancy scent or a test, or are there fees associated with whatever you do?
Everything that we do is free of charge
wow.
for every woman or man that we see in the mm-hmm. center. Mm-hmm. And we are in the process of becoming a medical center, praise the Lord,
mm-hmm.
Next month, where we will be offering ultrasound, and that's another free service.
Oh, that'll be free as well. So
yes.
they can come in and you know, the ultrasounds today, some of the newer ones, they really are amazing.
Yes.
I mean, I've just seen some of my granddaughter that's having a baby, and we've seen the ultrasounds, and you can actually see who this little one
yes.
looks like. I mean,
wow.
years ago you had to kind of point out
yes.
that this is, oh, there's a hand, and here's a little, you mm-hmm. know, foot or something. But the facial features were so distinct and beautiful, I couldn't believe it.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about the counseling component at the center. Are there services offered to men and women? You might want to direct that.
Well, I mean, the services are, I think more in the future they're going to be offered more to men, I mean, offered to men as well, but right now the women are being targeted. The men are referred to, there's a counseling center that's affiliated with the church.
Okay.
Greater Exodus Baptist Church has a counseling center, so the men who want counseling right now, they're being referred there.
Okay, but that is a plan, that because the men need counseling as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
I mean, seriously,
absolutely.
It takes two.
Where there's a pregnancy, there's not just a woman, there's a man involved as
exactly,
well.
Exactly, exactly. Now tell us about the was that your goal always to become a medical center as well?
Yes, it was. Since the very beginning, when we opened the doors in November 2008,
mm-hmm.
Pastor Luskin knew that the next step was going to be a medical center.
Now, when you say medical center, now you know you're going to do the ultrasound, but do you have to have an on staff, like nurse there? Or
we do.
Or how does that work? Tell us a little bit about that.
Our staff is now a registered nurse,
mm-hmm.
a nurse practitioner,
okay.
and we have a medical director
okay.
who is a general surgeon
mm-hmm.
and a radiologist.
Wow.
So we are very equipped and ready to be able to bless women with this service.
Mm-hmm.
And in the future, we will be opening it up to STI testing
yes.
and early prenatal care.
Okay.
And what's very important about the medical center is that approximately 70% of the women who see their baby on the ultrasound change their mind about
mm-hmm.
abortion.
Yes.
So that abortion-minded woman who comes in just ready to terminate her pregnancy, 70% of them will change their mind.
Isn't that wonderful?
That's
I mean,
amazing.
God is the author of life.
Yes,
I mean,
he
and once
is.
You see this little child within the womb there, and you know,
it's just not a blob of anything,
not.
You know?
And so many women think that. They are so misled and misguided when it comes to the precious baby that they are carrying.
Mm-hmm. Yes. We have to take a break right now for a short message. Don't go away. You're watching 60 Live. This is Christian television right here in the heart of the Delaware and the Lehigh Valley. And our special guests here are with the Hope Pregnancy Center. We will be right back with them after these few messages. Please stay tuned. And welcome back. In case you just tuned in and we're channel surfing, this is Christian Television right here in the heart of the Delaware and the Lehigh Valley. My name is Pat Huber. Our phone number and our address are going to be on the screen from time to time. 610-434-8200 is our prayer number. You can call that number anytime. Our address is there as well. Jot it down and hang it on the refrigerator where you have all those important messages and notes and dates and pictures hanging. So jot all that information down. Our special guests today are from the Hope Pregnancy Center, Nicole Showell and Vincent Calloway. Tell us about the staff at the center, Nicole.
Well, we are staffed with a nurse practitioner for our medical center.
Besides the medical staff, you also have to have volunteers there as well.
We are staffed with so many great volunteers. But who heads our, I want to talk about who heads our counseling department is Jane Nguyen. She is a licensed social worker, and she is great with all of our patients or clients that come in. Uh-huh. Then we have about 10 volunteers who are committed and dedicated to this work of saving lives and are consistent with their time and their gifts to the center. So they each champion a different component of hope, so we can all just be one successful organization and be able to service the city.
That's wonderful. Now tell us about the location and the hours of operation. There may be someone that's watching and they would like to know, well, where are you? Because you're relatively new. So when you're opened and how they can reach you.
Absolutely. We are at 716 North Broad Street, and that's in Philadelphia. Our telephone number is 267-546-3600. And our website is philadelphiapregnancy.org.
Okay, we bring it up from time to time on the screen, so if they didn't get it all when you were saying it, that they will have a chance to get a pencil and write it down in case they need that information. And your hours of operation?
Our hours are 9 to 5 Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday, and 10 to 6 on Thursday.
Okay, all right, That's wonderful. Now tell us about some success stories. That, you know, someone walked in and they were thinking of getting an abortion and they decided to keep the baby or whatever, whatever comes to your mind, because you must know many of them. And so without disclosing any personal information, you know, use some discretion. Would you share something with us?
I'd like to share two brief stories with you that I think are very important for everyone to know. One, we had recently had a woman come in who was set on abortion. And she thought that she could come in and that we were kind of on the fence, that we would do either, we would go either way, that we were not necessarily a pro-life organization. And she wanted us to agree with her that it's okay to abort your baby. And when she left, she already had her abortion appointment scheduled. She left our office that day and canceled her abortion appointment because of the love that she felt when walked into the center. She said it was nothing like anything she had ever experienced. It's not like the abortion providers, the clinic where she had previously been. And not only that, because we do have the church associated with the pregnancy center, She joined the church.
Oh, praise the
yes.
Lord. Hallelujah.
Yes. So all around, it's very comprehensive, the services that one receives at
yes.
Hope.
Mm-hmm.
And again, not just to save the life of the baby, but to save the life of that woman
exactly.
or that man who walks through the door.
Yes, yes.
And the other very important story is one who, after coming in, she had a pregnancy scare. She was not pregnant, but after her visit with us, decided to abstain from sexual intercourse.
Mm.
And that was another very, just a great thing that we were able to help her do and to really help her understand that her body is the temple and we want to be able to help her to be able to what's the word I'm looking for?
Value.
Yes, thank
value
you.
Value her body.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Not just her
yes.
body, her soul.
Yes.
Because there's, you know, psychological ramifications to practicing sex in a way that God has not really designed.
Exactly.
You know, there's all kinds of ramifications of that.
And like you said, you used the word before, many young people are very clueless
yeah. mm-hmm.
into a healthy, what would be considered normal biblical relationship.
Mm-hmm.
They really don't have an idea.
Yeah.
In fact, let's address the hot topic today. We're going to talk about the funds and everything in just a little bit. The right to choose versus pro-life. You wanted to address that, Vincent.
Yeah, I'm feeling some kind of way about how the whole question has been framed, you know, pro-life versus pro-choice. And I think that it starts off wrong because the choice that men and women have involves what they're going to do, how they're going to practice their sexuality. But after that, when a life has been conceived, there is a baby inside. And as a social worker, and in my profession, we take pride in advocating for those that are disenfranchised and those who don't have a voice. I don't hear enough said, I don't hear enough advocacy for the baby. The baby has no voice.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's getting lost in this argument. So I have a problem with the pro-choice, you know, versus pro-life. You know, we have to, it just ignores the baby. And we really need to take a look at the baby's rights as well. Who's speaking up for the baby? You know, there's many people that would have been aborted, but at the last minute, the mother changed her mind and these people became great people,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Absolutely.
So we have to really look at this argument, right? And I'm very disappointed that our politicians really won't look at the issue for what it really is.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody is fighting for, or not nobody, they're not really looking at the rights of the unborn child,
mm-hmm.
that is a child. It reminds me of the issue of slavery. Over 100 years ago, there was a time when African Americans were considered less than a human being, three-fifths
That's right.
of a human being.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was legalized. Slavery was, chattel slavery was legalized. African Americans were treated as property. And what it does, I guess it's a way, if you change the wording around, if you use the language and say we're really not a human being, then it doesn't prick the conscience.
Mm-hmm.
And I see the same phenomenon occurring with abortion. So you just change the wording, you know, you don't call it murder of babies, you call it abortion. You
mm-hmm.
know, you call the baby a fetus, you
mm-hmm.
know, you label the body parts, you know, it's not ripping out an arm or it's not burning the baby with a saline solution. It's all kinds of different terminology that is
mm-hmm.
used to dehumanize the baby and desensitize the public as to what's really going on.
They only say what's politically correct.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And that's, you know, it's dehumanizing in the grossest sense that I can think of. It really is.
And I think Vince had a really great point. It hides under the term women's right to
yeah,
choose or
yeah.
women's rights issues.
Yes. Yeah.
And it's a matter of life and death. It's
it
not.
Is. It is.
Mm-hmm. And actually the pro, I would say the Hope Center and all of the pro-life abortion clinics are really pro-women.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because
oh, yes.
we're really trying to do what is best for women, what's healthy for women, and we're trying to give them the information they're not getting.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that having an abortion is going to be very, very costly, not financially costly, but psychologically, emotionally, physically costly,
mm-hmm.
and relationally costly, and generationally costly as well.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is. Okay, Nicole, tell us about the upcoming fundraiser that you're having and how you are funded and perhaps our audience can help in some way. So
we are funded by donation mm-hmm. only.
Okay.
We do have a gala coming up on Friday, May 21st, from 7 to 9, and it's at St. David's Country Club in Wayne, Pennsylvania. And we're really hoping to be able to raise enough money to provide our services every day of the week. Right now, as a medical center, when we make this final transition, we won't be able to provide the ultrasound 5 days a week.
Okay.
Only three at this point. And we're really hoping now that with not only this gala, but with other donors who may be watching and want to contribute to our mission to save lives, that we will be able to provide it 5 days a week.
Now, I'm assuming that you're a 501c3.
We are.
Okay, so that if any of our studio audience or the audience out there in TV land, so to speak, they can go to your website. Are there directions there how they can contribute over the web?
Yes,
or should they call the office, or what should they do?
Any of the above.
All of the above, and you'll take any kind of money.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. But so they can go to the website, which we've had on the screen right now, and the phone number. It's Hope Pregnancy Center, and the website's there, and the phone number is listed. So we encourage our audience to help support, because we are definitely a pro-life station. We have 1 minute left, 30 seconds. What do you want to say in closing? Then I'll give her the last 30 seconds.
Just wanted to give a shout out to the men that are involved in this. And I think, and I'm encouraging all of the pregnancy centers that are pro-life to really target the men, because many women, most women, make the decision to abort the child because they don't have the support of the father of the baby.
Okay.
So if we can educate these men and reach out to these men and counsel these men, that's a very strategic thing to do.
Yes.
Okay, last few seconds.
Thank you so much. And not only that, but we also want to educate everyone, our families, our children, our young women, and the abortion number in young women and teens has increased. We want to really help women understand that it's not just a glob, like you mentioned. And they're getting so much misinformation. And even if they just want to come to us just for information, we are certainly open to that, and we welcome just informing and helping them make an informed decision.
We want to thank you both for being here today. We have to go right now. You're watching 60 Live. This is Christian Television right here in the heart of the Delaware and the Lehigh Valley. You don't go away, because I will be right back. I want to share a closing thought with you. We have to pray about whatever need you may have. And so please stay with us. The best is yet to come. We are going to pray. We'll be right back.